Every curious mind has lots of unanswered questions about our universe and celestial bodies. So, let's begin the question answer session.
How do we name stars?
Oh, depends. Long time ago, they named it after gods, mythological heroes. Now we have fancier things called digits, numbers, and alphabets. Yeah, but it's so nowadays, in fact, a lot of objects are named after their location in the sky. So we use a system called right ascension and declination to locate objects in the sky. It corresponds to latitude and longitude on Earth. So very often stars are named after their right ascension and declination.
Exactly which stars are named or to be seen frequently are named, or is it just random naming like that?
Question, as in the sense that stars that were discovered, you know, 100 years ago or 150 years ago, whatever, are more likely to have a name that sounds like a name, right? Otherwise, like, you know, he just pointed out, they'll be named after their position. If we happen to find a new star today, we will name it after its position, and perhaps, if it's a particularly bright star in a constellation or something identified through the constellation.
You can name 6,000 stars. You can't name 10 billion stars. That is the problem. So what was known to the visible eye often got individual names, as in not numbers. But even then, even constellations, it was named after actually Alpha Centaurus is the brightest star of the constellation Centaurus, Alpha Centauri. So similarly, you have Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Andromeda, and things like that. So they were also named after their brightness in the scale. So in some sense, there's also just like a number as a sequence itself. In fact, in many tribal societies also, they name kids after their sequence in the order in which they were born. It's true. So how do you find lots of names?
So the visibility and brightness of the star gives it the name or its
used to age. Be. That's one of the systems.
Or its age of how old the star.
Oh, they didn't know. 200 years ago, they didn't know how old it was.
But now today, if the star is named, is it according to its age?
Right ascension, declination.
Most of position.
Sir, but who is the organization that decides the naming?
Nobody decides. If you publish a research paper and you give it the name and you're the first one to give it a name, then it becomes part of it becomes its name. So there are organizations which take money from people and offer to name stars after them. You should watch out for them. It's true.
Then what are red giants?
So stars go through this sort of evolution in their own composition and size. Once all the hydrogen in a star's core has been exhausted, you only have helium left. And if the star is large enough, the helium it'll be hot enough that the helium will start to fuse. And at this point, the amount of energy in the star is so much that it pushes the gas that is on the surface further away. And so the star itself, you know, grows in size. So those are what we call red giant stars.
And coincidentally, that's what our sun is. That's the next phase of life for our sun in about 5 billion years from now.
Sir, what is going to be the last stage for our sun?
It will be a white dwarf.
Thank you, sir.